It's the world's fastest shed.
How fast?
Officially timed top speed is 113.7.
Wow.
Although I have done the quarter mile in 14.6 seconds at 98.5 miles an hour.
Today we're here to launch our Safer Schools app, and we do that in partnership with Zurich Municipal. So Zurich are an insurance company here, and they insure all the schools on the island. And in partnership we've developed the Safer Schools app, and it's designed to help educate and empower and protect the entire school community.
When they came to me in December and said we're going to start the work in January, just was like, crack on, you know. But we never imagined it was going to be like this. I mean, everybody I've talked to is shocked at the way this has proceeded. They just expected it to go block by block by block. Now, the interesting thing is when I tried to find out who agreed with whom to do it this way, I was told that Keith Podmore put his hand up and said it was me. And then now they're saying it was Alden's decision to do the central corridor. So we've never been told actually how this happened and why it's going the way it is.
Well, here we are down at the Villa Marina Gardens, and behind me is at least 800 fairies. The counters are going, the clickers are working, because the number they need is 878, I believe, and it's close. Let's go back to the Villiers Town Square. This is where everyone met at about 3 o'clock this afternoon, and certainly a great party atmosphere. Been delighted that the weather's on our side as well. That's made a big difference.
We were obviously aware that there'd been an approach with the department. The minister took a decision, and ultimately it lay with the minister. But we were all in support of that. We felt actually we've got a really positive service to offer, and that's something that we should, rather than try and hide it away, we should show people what we're doing.
So Department of Infrastructure have issued the information that these lights at Broadway are to come to the end of their useful life at the end of the month. Then they'll be closed for up to about 5 weeks, and then after that just a simple stop sign will be put in place here. That will be taking it back to what it was probably in the 60s before these lights were put in.
People are becoming more engaged in green matters. The average public are becoming more and more aware of it. It is on social media and the news all the time.
It's an important building, as you say, a Baillie Scott creation. It's called the old police station. Actually, it's the new police station. The old one was behind you, in the grounds of the castle originally. So this is not actually a very old building. It's a turn of the 20th century. But it is important. It's one of Baillie Scott's very imposing public works.
Remember when we started off with the studio in the Summerland complex there?
That was amazing.
Yeah, groundbreaking at the time, and the technology has totally changed, which is why you've come along today to have a look at the new technology that we're using here in the new studio.
So what's happened? All the old-fashioned stuff's gone and it's all gone digital, right?
Yes, of course. You'll remember the days of tape, carts.
Yeah.
Thousands of carts, and I can remember when we first launched Energy FM, we actually had a computer, and there was one computer, and that was it. It stored very little amount of music. It was mainly the adverts and the jingles, and we thought it was fantastic at the time, because we were able to get rid of the old carts, cartridges, and play stuff off the computer.
The first of this machine in the UK, so it's a phenomenal piece of equipment. I've been looking at pizza vending machines for years and years, and nothing's come up to the scratch that I would say we're quite happy to put our name on. But at a pizza show last year down in London, I saw this machine and thought, you know what, we've got to have it, and we're the first in the UK. Phenomenal.